My name is Matt Westgate. I'm going to talk to you about psychological safety today. I work for Tugboat. This totally dovetails into Rin's awesome talk this morning when she talked about psychological safety as being one of the most important things in DevOps. So to me, DevOps is two things. It's about safety and collaboration, and that needs to be in place before you can have an awesome DevOps culture and practice. Collaboration is really interesting, but we're only going to focus on the safety side for this conversation. So an example of not feeling safe, we've probably all been in those meetings where you kind of want to call BS on something and nobody else is doing it, but you don't feel safe enough to ask because maybe you think you're supposed to know or you missed a meeting. That's what it's like to not be willing to take that risk. If there's one thing to take from this slide, is this: go home to your organization and say you will not be punished or humiliated for speaking up with ideas, questions, concerns, or mistakes. That's psychological safety, and it can change the culture in your organization. Quick story about that. We did a database migration project for a Fortune 500 company. When we were doing the database migration, we had an off by one error on the users table. So user ID 1 was user ID 2. User ID 2 was user ID 3. When the company's lawyer called us and said he logged into the site and said he was a 14-year-old girl, I knew that we were in big trouble. The person that was responsible for the migration, she quickly spoke up and said, you know what, this is me, I did this, I didn't expect it to happen, but it did, let me fix the mistake. And she did, and we made it through. Later, I called her into the office, and she thought, oh dear, here it comes. And I said, you are our database migration expert from now on. And she said, what do you mean? And I said, if there's anybody that knows how to migrate data now, it's you. The point of that story is that failure is often seen as the opportunity. I don't think it is. Failure is not the opportunity. Psychological safety is. Like that site says. You know, if you think mistakes don't happen in your organization, the only thing that's happening is you don't know about the mistakes that actually are happening. And so I think all of it is predicated upon this. This is actually, Rin talked about this briefly. There's a lot of awesome research about psychological safety, and most of the research points to psychological safety being the most important thing for having an effective team. Everything else sort of stems from that. When it's not in place and we choose to withhold that information and don't share it with a team, we rob ourselves and our teams of small moments of learning and innovation, which seems to be crucial for the kinds of businesses that we're in. So how do you do it? What are the three steps? This research comes from Amy Edmondson, who's a Harvard professor who put this together. The three steps to psychological safety are: step one, to have the problem be a learning problem and not an execution problem. In other words, to say it's not all about, this is a big project, it's unknown, the work that we do is super complicated. I'm going to need everybody's voices and brains in the game. We need to work together on this. Number two is to be vulnerable and show that it's okay to be vulnerable. I'm not going to see everything that's happening. I need you guys to help hold me accountable, and I need to call, you need to see, shout things out when you see mistakes and other things. That's the only way that we're going to do this together. Number three is to be the behavior that you want your team to see. Ask questions, model curiosity, show them that it's okay to be inquisitive about the project that they're on. The good or bad news about this is that this usually comes from leadership. Leadership defines culture. Culture is what what the leader wants and how the leader wants to do it. Sometimes you have to replace the leader in order to get the environment that you want to create. Leadership aside, though, research also shows it's not who's on the team, but how well that team works together. It doesn't matter if they're co-located, you have extroverts, it's a team of really smart people. At the end of the day, it's what they can accomplish together that matters. My recommendation is to build the DevOps culture first, come back to that team, and then automate together. They're the ones out there on the front lines. They're going to know what the bottlenecks are. Don't go top down on the automation. Pull them in for support. My favorite collaborative tools, you've seen some here: version control, code reviews, and preview environments. The idea of preview environments is you build out a working preview for every branch of your code so that you can share it with people that don't have locals and can't follow along. I let an engineer review this slide with this talk, and she said, basically, I can sum it up for you like this. When you're on a team that has empathy, trust, and openness, DevOps tends to follow. She also liked pizza. Thank you.